pages detailing how the White House has been lying about the Vietnam War for 30 years.
The way they lied, those days have to be over.
Kay, people are concerned about having a woman in charge of the paper, that she doesn't have the resolve to make the tough choices.
Thank you, Arthur, for your frankness.
Let's do our jobs. Find those pages.
You're talking about exposing years of government secrets.
Is that legal?
What is it you think we do here for a living, kid?
Ben, I might have something.
It must be precious cargo.
It's just government secrets.
The New York Times was barred from publishing any more classified documents dealing with the Vietnam War.
If you'd publish, we'll be at the Supreme Court next week.
Meaning?
Well, we could all go to prison.
To make this decision, to risk her fortune and the company that's been her entire life, well, I think that's brave.
If the government wins, the Washington Post will cease to exist.
If we don't hold them accountable, who will?
We can't hold them accountable if we don't have a newspaper.
Nixon will muster the full power of the presidency, and if there's a way to destroy you, by God, he'll find it.
Aloha! This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, coming to you live once again from beautiful Hawaii here on the island of Oahu, bringing you, yes you, the best movie reviews on the entire island of Oahu. And yes, again, this is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man. And yesterday, Friday night, I went ahead, I saw a wonderful movie. Remember our rating scale? Shock a thumbs up. It's good to see. I recommend it. Shock a thumbs down. It's bad to see. It's junk. I don't recommend it. And, well, the movie I saw was The Post. Now, this stars Meryl Streep, Tom Hanks, and is directed by Steven Spielberg. So, overall, I have to give it a shock a thumbs up. This was a very good, entertaining, interesting movie that definitely goes ahead and follows step by step the historical happenings back in the 70s with the Washington Post and the Nixon presidency and administration. Essentially, what takes place, Tom Hanks is the editor of the Washington Post, portraying Bill Bradley, and Meryl Streep plays the owner of the Washington Post at that time, which she was Kay Graham. And essentially what happens in about 1971 is that someone leaks classified documents about a study that the government did about how it's handling the Vietnam War at that time, which had taken place, I believe, some point from the 50s all the way up into the 70s, into the early 70s. And essentially, what this leak study shows is that despite all efforts that the United States have done to reach their goal of, you know, winning the war against, you know, Vietnam, you know, the communists in Vietnam, or even, you know, to hold back the Russians and communists throughout the world in the defense of the domino theory, whereas if, you know, communist countries take over, then the entire world will fall, essentially. Well, the study finds that this is an error. It finds that the tactics, the strategy that the United States has been using for over a decade in this war, where hundreds of thousands of U.S. soldiers had been lost, you know, their lives, snuffed out, mere teenagers, and of course, you know, looking back on history, most of those lives were from the lower economic class. So, you know, the rich paying for a war that is for naught, using the lives of people they consider, you know, inferior, apparently. At least that's one conclusion. That's the very basic conclusion that one person could go ahead and draw. And that same argument has been brought up time and time again. But essentially what happens is that these leaked papers get to the Washington, well, get to originally the New York Times. The New York Times prints one story of these, and the Nixon administration, President Nixon himself, has the Attorney General go ahead and issue basically a restraining order saying that if they continue to publish any of these classified documents, everyone at the New York Times would be basically arrested and tried for treason. So the New York Times stops publishing and is going to let the lawyers take its case. Now, in this verdict, the New York Times was targeted. So the Washington Post gets off their laurels, finds their source through a great showing of investigative journalism and reporting, and starts to publish the papers on their own from the Washington Post, making them a small town paper into a large national newspaper, which it is known for today. And this really puts them on the map, but squarely in the target sights of Richard Nixon, the president at that time, and the entire administration. So the Times, the Washington Post, all go against the Nixon administration, because this information has to be known to the public. You know, American lives are being lost, and, you know, it is the duty of the First Amendment to get this news out there so that the public can be informed to make an intelligent, decisive decision on, you know, what they want to continue to do with the war, or listen to the lies of the propaganda machine with the administration trying to continue the war despite everything failing up to that point in 71. So it goes all the way up to the Supreme Court, and lo and behold, the Supreme Court defends and upholds the First Amendment, freedom of speech, so they are able to go ahead and publish that. Several other newspapers join in with the Washington Post, and there you have it. That is the moral of the story. That is the lesson learned in the story, and the beautiful way that it ends, since there's not really any spoilers, since this is a historical documentary almost, that it ends right at the very beginning of the Washington, you know, in Washington, D.C., at the Watergate Hotel break-in at the Democratic National Convention Party. Committee party there at the Watergate Hotel. Thugs from the Nixon administration, I believe, break in to steal documents, and they are caught, at which begins to unravel through the other movie, All the President's Men, the Nixon administration, and finally force President Nixon to resign, vice getting impeached for committing these crimes. So yes, this is a shock a thumbs up for the Post. Meryl Streep and Tom Hanks are, as always, very good. Steven Spielberg does a fine job directing this, which he does most things. I feel that it has, he put this out, it came out wide release here in 2018, January, this last Friday. But I feel that, Steven Spielberg did put this out a little bit earlier in December on a limited release so that it would, garner Academy Award nominations. And I think it has a decent chance of getting Best Picture for 2017. If not, then I feel Best Director. Again, both Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep do knockout performances. However, I think, they've already been awarded very well by the Academy, both of them, so I don't think that their performances stand out that much to where they will go ahead and make, or receive awards for that. So it's either going to be Best Director or Best Picture for this movie, and I feel that the main push for Best Picture will come, as this is basically a sampling of the times that we live in currently. Whereas the president, you know, then in the 70s, President Nixon, sought to hinder free speech, stop the right of the press from informing the people. Here, you know, in today's, we can draw in, you know, a similar correlation and comparison to the Trump administration. Although he is not taking legal attacks against the media, against news sources, he continues to put out tweet after tweet, social media assail, you know, attacks almost on a daily basis against reputable media outlets and news sources, claiming that they're all fake news, thus minimizing the information the American people have access to, can receive, to make these informed decisions that affect their everyday lives. So I think this is definitely a time, this is definitely the right time for Steven Spielberg to put this movie out. It was said that he had wanted to put this movie out at this time, obviously in defense of the press that has been asundered by President Trump, very much resembling right now the Nixon administration on many levels. And so I feel that the Academy will most likely give this movie, The Post, a Best Picture nod and award, if not, then Best Director. Again, it is a shock of thumbs up. Anyone interested in history, anyone interested in the Vietnam War, anyone interested in today's use of the media, the spin that people put on it, the Fox Newses of the world, need to go ahead and watch this movie and see how originally things were handled, and see how, you know, much these resources that have been weakened financially by Time and by other news outlets, other news sources, especially social media, still need to be vigil and defended against, vice, have them be forced or pushed away by those who do not want the truth to get out there. All right. Thank you so much. Getting a little preachy here, the Island Man. This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, live from Hawaii, giving you a shock of thumbs up for The Post. Definitely check it out on the $6 Tuesday or the $7 Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday over at Consolidated. $6 only at Regal, of course, on Tuesday. So check it out, and you can't go wrong with that movie. Again, like I said, you know, this is adult fare. Millennials will enjoy it, maybe teenagers, especially if, you know, they have an interest in history, they have maybe want to have some type of discussion or looking into a paper for school. This is a nice, easy way to get, some thoughts into your head on what to write about. Definitely check out this movie when you can. All right, thank you so much, and aloha.